Above you, and longer if I can. How long will I need you? As long as the seasons need to follow their plan. How long will I be with you? As long as the sea is bound. Sand. How long will I want you? As long as you want me to, and longer by far. How long will I hold you? As long as your father told you. As long. Above you, and longer if I may.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Mood Place on this very special day for Millie and for Scott. Would you all please take your seats? I'd like to introduce myself and my colleague. My name is Francis Smith and I'm a Deputy Superintendent Registration Officer and I have the privilege and pleasure of actually carrying out the radio ceremony. And my colleague in the corner there writing away is Sally Ann Beards, and Sally is the Registration Officer with the legal responsibility of the completion of the marriage entry into the marriage register, thus creating this very historical yet local event. I do have to inform you that we are both Registration Officers from the Hampshire County Council's ceremonies team. Now today, it is a wonderful opportunity to bring the respective families and friends of both the bride and groom together in this place to enable them to witness and to celebrate as they do become husband and wife. Very shortly, I will be asking the bride and groom to publicly declare that they are both free lawfully to enter into this marriage. They will then enter into the contract of their marriage and there will be an exchange of two wedding rings which will be brought forward by them. However, before we commence with the wedding ceremony, I do have to ask the bride and groom to publicly state their full names in front of you all. So, Scott, your full name, please. Scott, thank you very much. And Millie? Thank you very much. I do have to inform you all that this place in which we are now met has been duly licensed and sanctioned according to law for the celebration of civil marriage. And you are all here today to witness the joining of matrimony between Scott Thomas Kendall and Amanda Denise Hughes. And if any person present knows of any lawful impediment or has a valid legal reason as to why this couple may not be joined in marriage, you should declare it to myself and Sally right now. You guys have been well paid there. We're paying that five is available. That's a good sign. Okay, Scott and Millie, before you are actually joined in matrimony, I do have to remind you both of the very solemn and binding character of the vows that you are about to make here today. Now, marriage, according to the law of this country, is the union of one man with one woman, voluntarily entered into for life, to the exclusion of all others. It's also a very big requirement that demands respect, consideration, care, and patience. Now, marriage should not be entered into lightly, nor should it be lightly set aside. I'm now going to ask you both in turn to publicly declare in front of your family and friends that you are both free, lawfully to marry each other. Are you ready to make these declarations? Yes, great. To you first, Scott, if you could please repeat after me. I do solemnly declare that I know not.
I know not.
You said that I know not. That I know not. Of any lawful impediment. Of any lawful impediment. Why I, Scott Thomas Kendall.
Why I, Scott.
They are all before that. May not be joined in matrimony to Amanda Denise Hughes. And your turn now, Kelly. I do solemnly declare that I know not of any lawful impediment. Why I, Amanda Denise Hughes, may not be joined in matrimony. No, not her. This is not religious. I have to say that again. May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Scott Thomas Kendall. Well done. It's long been tradition in many parts of the world for the bride's hand to be given away in marriage. And Ben, Millie's son, is here today to fulfil this tradition and to formally welcome Scott into the family. Ben, come to step forward, please. Now, please take your mum's left hand and Scott your left. But before you do, I'm going to ask you two questions. I'm telling you now, I want to answer. Ben, are you happy and willing to give your mum's hand? Just hold those two together for a while. Well, Scott, you are here today to support your mum and to show your appreciation and love of your mum. As you pass the hand into Scott's, for his safe keeping and his future wife, I want you now to shake his hand to welcome him into the family. Alright, thanks very much, Ben. Well, Scott and Millie, you have invited your family and friends here today to witness and become a part of your marriage. So I ask you now to respond with the words, I do, to these two small questions. Scott, do you willingly and freely take Millie to be your wife? Do you promise to love her and to remain true to her for the rest of your life? Millie, do you willingly and freely take Scott to be your husband? Do you promise to love him and to remain true to him for the rest of your life also? Ladies and gentlemen, we're now moving towards the contraction of the marriage, which is the most important part of the ceremony here today. When Millie says her final two words within her vows, that is the moment the actual marriage is taking place. Therefore, I'd like you all to stand and to share the same with her, please. I ask you two to turn and face each other, join all the hands together. Okay, Scott, if you could just look into each other's eyes, please, and just listen to what I'm going to say, and just repeat after me. Okay, Scott? I call upon these persons here present to witness that I, Scott Thomas Kendall, do take thee, Amanda Denise Hughes, to be my lawful wedded wife. I call upon these persons here present to witness that I, Amanda Denise Hughes, do take me, Scott Thomas Kendall, to be my lawful wedded husband. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for standing and sharing. Please have your seats today. I'm now going to do a very small reading which encapsulates what marriage is and what it should be. Now, happiness in a marriage is not something that just happens. A good marriage must be created. Within marriage, the little things like good things, the start is never being too old, the hold hands, proudly and comfortably. This is exactly what we started now doing in front of you all. Just remember to say I love you this once a day and try to maintain this. It is also laughing together at things that no one else finds funny. Things that are unique to a couple. Such as yourself if you're doing this. It's just having a big hug now and again, just because you want to. It is at no time taking each other for granted. The courtship should not end with a honeymoon. It should continue throughout the years. It is asking, how was your day? And being genuinely interested in one another at all times. It's asking, once again, and remembering to make each other feel special and to show full appreciation and to show the care, the consideration and the respect that commands within a marriage. Now, most importantly, it's standing together, facing the world, in the knowledge that you are surrounded by your family and friends. Now for you both today, Millie and Scott, it's about adventure as husband and wife. Today, it's been witnessed by your family and friends. On behalf of Sally and myself, we do sincerely wish you both a very long and happy, fulfilled marriage. We will now exchange the wedding ring, which is the ancient and traditional way of sealing the contract of the marriage. Now everyone in this room knows that these rings, that they are metal. They have no beginning, they have no end. What they do is that they symbolise the love and loyalty which is shared between two people. Millie and Scott, I ask you to wear these wedding rings you're about to receive with love and pride, but more importantly, as a symbol of the promises that you have made to each other here today and in place. But more importantly, these are the promises you've made in front of your family and your friends. Phil, please come forward, please. Hey Phil, could you represent the ring to Scott as they give to Millie? As long as your father told you. If you can now place that ring on his wedding finger. Millie, I give you this wedding ring as a token of my love and affection. All that I have, I share with you. As long as stars are above you. Millie, your response is saying to this wedding ring. I accept this wedding ring, Scott, as a sign of our love, our marriage, and my full commitment to you. I give you this wedding ring, Scott, as a token of my love and affection. All that I have, I share with you. All that I am, I give to you. I give to you. And once again, Scott, your acceptance of the ring. I accept this wedding ring, Millie, as a sign of our love, our marriage, and my full commitment to you. You now join your hands together. And Phil, thank you very much for being best man. Well, ladies and gentlemen, just to summarise exactly what's taking place here today at Noon Place, is that you have all witnessed the fact that both Scott and Millie have made the declarations prescribed by law to state that they were both free, lawful to marry each other. They have also made a very solemn and binding contract, once again, in your presence, family and friends. Therefore, ladies and gentlemen, we have great pleasure in declaring that Scott and Millie are now husband and wife. Give a round of applause in here.
Will I want you as long as you want me to, and longer by far? How long will I hold you as long as your father told you?